Hey guys, and welcome to Tharsis, a new series I'm doing here on YouTube. Pretty much the first gaming series I'm going to be doing under this channel. And I need to apologize in advance. I have recorded this prior to the other episodes I have been doing. But in the confusion from switching from streaming on Twitch to loading up the game and beginning to record videos for YouTube, I left my microphone on mute. And it is such a rookie mistake, and it is really sickening because of all the tutorial stuff I did in this episode. So I'm going to do the best I can post-production here to explain what's going on. As you saw on the main screen, there are missions, but they're coming soon, so they're not available yet. This screen right here is your character selection screen. The four main characters are up top. What it says in the box is their specialty ability. If you roll a certain number, you can take a benefit from that. Some get a specialty, like plus one reroll on our specialist. It's like passive, it's always there. And then other people have an active specialty, and I'll explain them as we go. There were also other crew members you can accrue due to getting achievements and stuff. But again, well, I do a better job explaining that as the game goes on throughout the episodes. If you are interested in just going directly to some episodes that have live commentary, you're going to need to start on episode 3. Episode 2 also had the mic muted. My stats going into this, I've played 3 games before recording on YouTube. I won one of them. And then you can see other stats there, like food harvested 9, human meals 3. Yeah, you can be a cannibal in this game and eat some meals. I'll explain that later. 1 out of 3 is pretty good compared to all the other things I've seen on like Steam reviews and stuff. Everyone complains that this game is unfairly hard, and I was lucky enough to at least win one of my matches before starting the record. And from here on out, I'm pretty much going to record every match I play just to have the continuity. We're back at the character selection screen here. You can see the achievements that you need to earn to unlock other people. Like to the right of the pilot I'm circling is the technician. Harvest 20 food, you unlock the technician. The doctor has a plus one health to crew. The captain has a plus one die to crew in the module. That means if you roll a certain number and put it into their specialty, you can give the plus one to everybody who's already in that module. So sometimes you want to make an effort to roll these guys last or move them into a module that other people are already in to roll. It helps out long-term. Health is important. Dice is really important. And, you know, certainly other things like the mechanic, the plus one, the ship, is very important too, to get the ship HP. But the pilot, the ignore movement damage, is not a big concern to me. I don't really use the pilot too much because of that. Movement damage happens when you cross modules that have an event current, like a impending damage event inside of them. They're tricky to get around. Most of the time you just want to clear them anyway. Sometimes you have to suck it up and take the damage, but other times you can get ignore movement damage in a specific module of the ship, and I'll show that in a bit, or through a use of a research card, and those will be explained as well. I'm going to check off view tutorial here. It will really nauseatingly bring up other options, other menus, other screens, other toasts, if you will, to show off exactly how to play the game. And it'll be easier for me to explain while you guys see it on the screen at the same time. That's why I did it. Okay, so this is the tutorial mission, if you will. It's if you see on top of the screen, it's 10 weeks to Mars. It's basically 10 rounds until you get to Mars. In between rounds, you get damage to the ship if you didn't clear all the events, and you have a choice from your crew to like an interaction in between events to that will give you ship but sacrifice health, give you health but sacrifice dice, stuff like that. There's also a stress mechanic as well. But this is the tutorial one. It only shows up if you have view tutorial. And basically, you're controlling one crew member, and you have one module to go into. So if you see up top, you see that triangle with the one in it. You have to roll a one in there to clear the event. And if you don't, you sustain one ship damage. And I'm showing you with the mouse pointer in the top left of the screen. Ship HP and, like, impending damage. So you can see at a glance how much in trouble you are round around. Knowing if you have to get ship health or you have to clear damage to survive for the next round. But on the crew member card, on the right-hand side there is your health. Up to 6 HP to start. It can decrease the health containers, that is, not just your health, by certain events. And on the bottom is the amount of dice you roll. Every time you roll, you lose a die for the next turn. The next round, not the next reroll. Every crew member gets one reroll. The specialist has a passive ability where they can reroll an additional time, though. So take those into consideration. On the bottom, you see the cards that are available. They're like your chance cards, your community chess cards. Basically, you have dice. If you can't fit the dice anywhere, you can put them into a research area. Dice 1 to 6. You can only put one of each number into there. So if I wanted to play that plus 2 assist card, I would have to put 2 dice in the research area and then click the card to use it. The top right of your screen, you see assists and food. Food give you 3 more dice, and you can use the food in between rounds, basically. And the assists happen when you roll event dice, like stasis dice that I'm showing you right there in the blue. That 3, if I roll a 3, it becomes a stasis die. And what that means is it's frozen. You can't reroll it unless you have an assist. But you don't have the choice. The assist will automatically be used. Other event die include, like, the orange dice are hazard dice. They're damage dice. Injury dice is what they call it. You'll lose HP every time you roll that specific number. It could be multiple numbers, or it could be multiple damage rolling the same numbers. It all depends. And then there's purple dice, which are void dice. If that 3 was purple and I rolled it and did not have any assists, it becomes void. It disappears from the playing field. You can't use it. You don't lose it towards next turn, but you can't use it. So right here, we're in the module. We have to roll a 1 to repair this module. The specialist here for our dude is plus 1 food. So if I roll a 1 or higher, indicated by required, I can put it in there and gain 1 food for the next round, or 1 food for our crew that I can use in the next round. On the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see the module's name is the pantry, and its special ability is the fact that you can gain food if you roll what's required, a 1 or higher in this case, and it gives you 4 food. So this is a pretty big module, very important. It's very easy to roll food here, and the food give you plus 3 dice, remember, in between turns, and your crew member loses 1 die every time they take a turn. So on the left-hand side, I'm circling crew in module. So that is important to notice, because our doctor and our captain, as I showed you before, can give people health or dice if they roll their specialty ability. So again, you want to plan out who you bring where and in what order, just to maximize your survivability. And manage your dice, manage your health, and stuff like that. So eventually here, I'm going to be rolling 4 dice. And I'll show you exactly what I do and what I put it. Now, this is the tutorial round, so everything's a 1 or higher. So there's no way I can lose this. So I'm going to put 1 in the class, get 1 food for our crew. Put 1 in the specialty of the module, get 4 food for our crew. And then put 1 in the repair that will repair, and then we won't sustain damage. So I rolled 1 or higher on everything, 4, 2, 4, 5. And I will be putting these in the available places soon. On the left, you can see the hazards now, your injury dice, your stasis dice, your void dice. So if I confused you a little bit, you can see there what they mean. And in the top right-hand corner, it does point out the assists that if you do roll one of those hazards, it uses an assist automatically to prevent it. So I'm going to take the 2. Maybe not. Maybe I'm not done explaining yet. But I've played enough games here now to know exactly how to explain this game to somebody. I did it on Twitch recently. That's going to be episode 5. That's going to be loaded. It's already there and waiting. I'm just waiting for this one to be finished and to re-record episode 2 before I do it. Just so it's in order. But again, episode 1 is a tutorial thing. I'll be explaining everything ad nauseum. Episode 2, I go right into the gameplay. A little less explanation about everything, but a little bit more in detail about what I'm doing and why. But I have to re-record the voice on that. So if you can go right to episode 3, you'll get the live recording, live reactions and stuff to what I'm doing. So I guess I'm taking a really long time to explain this, and now I'll start moving dice into the appropriate area. Hopefully. It's almost like I'm like popular enough to go back to like one of my first videos and be like, how did I do? What did I sound like? How long did it take me to explain stuff? And yeah, like I'm only like 6 episodes into recording and I already feel like I'm a lot better off than I was here. So I take the 2 into the repair. You notice the repair was 1 and the 2 was more than what it was. You don't get a rebate and you don't have to be exact. You just do it and the event is incomplete. You don't have to clear the event though every single time you're in the terminal. You can take a second, a third person in there and just chip away at it. Go after what you really want to go after, your specialist ability or the module's ability, and then just keep throwing people at the module and eventually get it done. So the 4 goes into the class. You'll see up there in the upper right-hand corner of the screen, I got an additional piece of food. Now, there's only 3 spots left for food, so when I put the 4 in there and gain 4 additional food, I only have 5 total up top when I should have 6. Diminishing returns, there's a cap to assists, which is 3. There's a cap to the amount of food you can hold, which is 5. Now I have 1 die left over, and I can put it into the research projects. Like I said before, that holds dice of a specific value. I can't put 2 5s down there, but I can put my 1 5 down there. Every number in the pink is the number of dice I need stored, not the total value, number of dice stored to use that card. That beaker fills up, or it doesn't fill up, the number just goes up. You know, if I put the 5 in there, it'll turn to 1, indicating I have 1 die stored in research projects. The 1 with the little circle arrow underneath the beaker is a reroll. So at the cost of 1 die, I can reroll all 3 cards to get something else if I don't like what's there. Keep in mind, the cards are very important. Knowing what you have there affects your decisions. They can be a enhancement to what you do in a round, or they can be like your safety net, your lifeline. You may want to sacrifice dice in there to re-roll to get something what you want to set something up for later. Anytime you use dice in that area for a card or for a re-roll, it goes in order from left to right. So if there was a 1, a 3, and a 4, and I used override assist, it would take out the 1 and the 3. If I only had a 4, 5, and 6 in there, and I can't put the 5 down there because I already have a 5. I use override assist, it takes out the 4 and the 5, then I can put the 5 down there. So if you want to minimize diminishing returns, sometimes you may want to use a card just so you can save another die and set yourself up later. Give yourself a little bit of a bonus, and you don't really hurt yourself going forward. So here's what happens after the week. Well, this is a little cutscene. There's our pantry. Our pantry just went bye-bye. So all those sweet rolls that we can get for all the food is no more. There was a person in that... For every disaster. Not all of them at once. We can't turn back, but how can we go on? Sorry about that. I want to play the cutscenes with full audio, so... What happened there was a crew member was in that module. The module got destroyed by a meteor. That's a one-time event that happens because of the tutorial. Our pantry goes bye-bye. We can no longer harvest or store food in there. There was also 1 other crew member on board, and they died. So, rip. Rip other person. But that's like a sample of your between-round actions. And this is basically the start of the game because you're not going to be playing in tutorial mode anymore. So as soon as I clear that screen, you'll see 2 events showed up. The number indicates what you have to roll total to get rid of them. The red area, the system failure, and the 2 bars indicates what kind of damage you'll have going into the next round if you don't clear them. System fails means you just can't use the specialty in that terminal until you clear that event. So right now it's an area where you can regain dice. So if I bring anyone in there, I cannot regain dice until I clear the module first. The one on the right, the 2 red bars, is impending damage. I'll take 2 damage to the ship, basically 2 HP. With 4 crew members, you have to select a crew member first, and then select the module, and then deploy. and you bring them in there. But you can always back out before you make a turn. So it's kind of like poker, where if you're making a bet, like, you can count out your chips first, think about it, and then it's not only until you push the chips into the center of the table does the bet really count. So I need a 12 here. Two dice are in stasis. So if I roll any 2, any 3, they'll be in stasis. And I'm showing you right now how you can back out before you go in. Remembering with the stasis die, there will be assists. So it will take an assist from you automatically if I roll on the first 2 or 3 I roll. Okay. I think I'm explaining all that now, that I can go pretty much anywhere. Okay. I'm explaining right now, if I go... Since I'm stuck in that module that has the event, if I go anywhere else, I will lose health. And if I go to the right, I'll lose 2 health, because I'll be running through 2 modules. And there it is right there. You'll see minus 2 health. So that will kill Allison if I do that. And I don't want to do that. So sometimes having everybody on the front of the ship or having everyone in the back of the ship, it's pretty hard. Because if something detrimental happens elsewhere in the ship, you might have to be running through two or three events to get there. And if you have something with you don't take movement damage, it's good. But if you don't have anything like that, you're really running a risk and putting yourself behind. You have to either clear every event to get to that last one, or you have to take the damage to get there. And if that event has injury dice as well, you're pretty much having a bad time right there. But I should be selecting Allison now and having Allison roll inside the event, the OAE fail for a system failure. As I watch this now, I'm gonna up the resolution of this game, starting at episode 7 onwards, since everything else is already created. It just looks a little bit pixelated to me when I'm looking at it at full screen, and I apologize for that. I'm pretty new to optimizing my videos for YouTube and stuff like that. I've been streaming on Twitch regularly, mostly the game Marvel Heroes, for the last, I would say, 4 or 5 months now. And I've been doing wrestling podcasts on the side on Twitch, Hitbox, and on YouTube. So not foreign to creating content, but also not a perfectionist yet. And seeing stuff like this is kind of wearing on me. So I apologize in advance. It's a little embarrassing, but I'll get it sorted by episode 7. If you have any other suggestions based on, the live commentary stuff starting on episode 3, just let me know. I'm open for everything. If you want to hear me explain more, if you want the volume increased on the cutscenes, if you want to see the cutscenes, because I've started canceling out of them, just let me know. If I remember right, what I'm doing here is I'm just really overemphasizing the fact that you have to make your decisions. Everyone starts with a random amount of health, random amount of dice. I'm very low on dice. I'm very low on health on certain people, so I really have to plan things out. I have to worry about the stasis dice and all that, and I have to prioritize where I'm going. That 23 is pretty big. The person with the most dice right now is my doctor, but I'll take that in a second. I just hit the ship info, and it says on the left-hand side where the mouse is right now what all of our specialist abilities are and what they do. But more importantly, that button shows you which each module does if you're not familiar with it right now. Flight control has no movement damage, roll a 5 or higher. Other things like reduce stress on the bottom for operations is 5 or higher. On the right hand side, the maintenance is ship repair. It's any number, but only a double will give you a benefit, and a triple will give you additional benefit. Same thing for harvest food, that second one from the left for greenhouse. Life support is any number regains dice, and then matching that number regains more dice. And that's more prominent when you bring a second person into that terminal, because it regains 2 dice. So most of the time, regaining 2 dice is enough. That second regaining dice is either diminishing returns or not an option. Health recovery is good too, because any 5 or higher in that area gives you full health. And the laboratory up top increases assists. It gives you 3 assists. It maxes your assists. So you don't want to roll in there if you have 2 assists. But sometimes you have to farm in there just so you can avoid injury dice and stuff like that. These are the things I've learned as I started playing, that sometimes maybe you don't want to go and take care of an event right away, but you need to farm things like ship repair just so you can stay alive, or increase insists just so you can get rid of a bad event in another module that just is like littered with injury or void dice. Or if you're really at low health, you can just take care of health recovery. if you survive, you get those actions in between turns, and you'll see plenty of them in this video, that just set you up for the next round, whether it's sacrificing ship health at the cost of adding a die to somebody's roll, or everyone's roll. You know, they can be any combination of stuff. They're affected by stress, too. And the stress indicator is on the left-hand side of that player card, that little, everyone seems to be at like 50% stress in green, and it goes up. So I'm going to take Pascal, and I'm going to bring him into the medical bay. It's a 23 repair. He's already there anyway, so he takes no damage getting into it. 4 ship health, 2 impending damage on the ship, and both that damage comes from this module. So it's probably more important for me to get rid of this than it is to get rid of the area that keeps me from getting new dice. I roll a 6 and a 4. I stay away from the stasis dice, so I don't use assists. And that's a pretty good roll. It's a 10 roll out of a max 12. So I'm going to hold the 6, and am I going to reroll the 4? I don't remember. It's like suspenseful. I probably don't. I probably dump that right into the repair and get on with it. I could take the 6 and put it in health recovery and gain 3 HP on him. Or I can take the 6 and put it into his specialty and get +1 ship HP. But I think it's more important here at this specific time to get rid of this repair. So I'm going to probably dump all 10 points into repair, and I'm kind of rooting for myself to do that. There it is. 4 goes into there, 6 goes into there, and it goes down to 13. So now his turn's done. I have 3 people left on this round, and I've minimized this damage to 13. Now, everyone else on the ship has to take that event first, that system failure event first, or they sustain damage if they go into the meteoroid strike. So I'm probably bringing Kayla into there is what I'm explaining right now with the mouse. She has the most dice. She has low health, but she's not at risk of losing health in there. Best case scenario is I roll 2 sixes and a 5 or a 6, so I can give the ship the repair and give her +1 health. I rolled a 2, which is a stasis die in this module. It used my last assist. So I can just get rid of this event right now. I rolled a 12. You see in that big box in the middle, the repair 12, nice and big. And then there's that little lower left-hand corner. There's that little 12. That's just the sum of all the dice I rolled for this turn. So it's a nice quick glance to say that that's what you got. If I pick up a dice, it also has a number on the lower right-hand corner. And that says how much is left if you would use this towards the repair. So Kayla rolled a 12, needed a 12, got that sorted. Got nothing additional from it, but killed at least one of my events. Allison and Jean. Allison has 2 dice. Jean has 1 die. I have no assist left. 2 stasis dice, so this is scary. Neither can take damage or get hurt, but if they all roll 2s, I can't clear this module, and I'm taking 2 damage on this turn, and that event stays with me till next turn. So you definitely want to get rid of the events like as fast as possible. So we're going to take Allison. She has the reroll, but we have to worry about the stasis dice more than anything. And I rolled a 3 and 4. So 3 is in stasis. Now, what's interesting to note here is that if I used anything in the specialty for the module, like the health recover on the right-hand side, if I used it on Allison and then brought someone else in here in the same round, it's already been used. So I can't farm it with multiple people. Allison put her die in there. It's been used. Next person that comes in here cannot use it. Allison's die is still in there and nothing else can happen. I put the 3 in the repair and I contemplate what I'm going to do with the 4, if I'm going to reroll it or not. Explaining that I probably could put it in research projects, but we really need this gone. We need it wiped off the board, and we need to start new next round, because more events are coming. They come every round. Between 2 and 3, and I think at least 1 in the last round. So I brought it down to 6. That means Jean has to roll a 6, or we don't get rid of this event. Now, considering the fact that if Jean had 2 dice, I rolled a 1, so I'm probably going to reroll. And it turns into a 4. So I'm probably going to put the 4 into the repair, knock it down to 2, and that ends the turn. So there's a cutscene. knowing that I'm going to take 2 damage after this turn because I couldn't get this down to nothing. Cutscene's coming. There's our damage. Knocked 2 HP off, and here's the cutscene.
Moods are turning sour. The crews and my own. But if I can't lead them, we're all dead. I need to get it together.
Alright, here's our after round, after action choices. So, I can take 2 assists and lose 1 ship. And remember, we get 1 assist. Not remember, I'm telling you this for the first time. You get 1 assist per round. So 2 assists will bring me up to maximum, but I lose 1 ship HP, and I only have 2. You can go back and hit view ship on the top left to check your status at any time. See, I have 2, and we have an event that's taken away 2, so that's probably not good. Or I can get 1 dice for all crew, 1 die for all crew, at the cost of 2 health just for those people on the right-hand side. Kayla only has 2 health. That kills her. So I have to take the option... I don't have to, but I probably will take the option to give myself 2 assists and lose 1 ship, and then just hope I farm ship HP, or if I, just get rid of all the events and take no damage. And that's the choice I was going to make. What I was going to say before is, if I was in a terminal and that one has a 2 left on it, if I roll like a 2-5-4-4 with Gene, and I take out, I take it out, like I clear the module with a 2, there's no more hazard dice left. Like, once you clear the module, the hazard dice disappear. So I can free roll in there for other stuff and not have to worry about getting injured if the event's done. Food is 3 dice. So I gave 1 to Pascal, and I'm probably deciding which one to give it to, Gene or Allison. Probably Allison, because Allison has the reroll, and that could be beneficial towards those modules that have a larger amount of... We'll call it HP, damage HP, we have to clear. I could also give it to Kayla, but I always tend to use the food where it's not diminishing returns, so only giving it to people who have 2 dice or less. And I do wind up, I know it's being so dramatic about it, I don't know what I could possibly be saying. Give it to Allison, because Allison has the rerolls. Come on, dude. Like, I could definitely, this is the point in time where you yell at people, like, when you're watching their videos, you're like, just do it. Give it to Allison. What's there to think about? Just do it. And then you hear somebody explain something, and you're just like, that's just the wrong thing to do. So, 2 events. We have a 15 on the front of the ship. It has an injury die and a stasis die. It gives 1 damage to the ship. And at the top, in the laboratory, there's 2 stasis die for an 11 event, and -1 health all, which is worrisome because we have 2 units at 2 health. Trying to figure out what I want to do here. I'm full on assists, so when you have assists, you probably want to tackle things that have injury dice first, or void dice, because stasis dice, I mean, they can screw you over, but they're not going to injure you. So if you waste your assist on stasis dice, it's probably more beneficial to be wasting them in a role where you can take damage or die. I take Gene into there to finish it off. He has 1 die. What's the worst that can happen? I can eat 1 assist is probably what I'm saying. I rolled a 5. I probably just clear it and be done with it. There we go. So if he had a 2nd die, let's say, the stasis dice would no longer exist. That's what I was trying to say before. And he can free roll to farm health in that module or an extra die for his next turn for his specialty. Now, anybody else in that module can go wherever they want without the risk of a penalty, so that's probably why I took care of that first. I didn't use an assist, so I got lucky. Pascal has 4 dice. Allison has 4. Pascal is going to go into this terminal because with 4 dice, he can... utilize the module specialty, roll doubles and you get 2 ship health, roll triples and you can get 3 ship health, roll a 5 or more and he can also add 1 more ship HP based on his specialty. So a good roll of all 4 dice here and I can get plus 4 HP. No doubles yet. I'm going to save the 5. I'm going to just use the 5 right away on the ship because if I can't clear that other terminal, at least I know now I have 2 ship HP and it won't kill me in between. It won't blow up the ship in between rounds. Now I'm hoping for doubles. I don't get doubles. I'm going to store all these in the research project. And at least have three in the bank for whenever I need them. The dice hold you see on the bottom right-hand side of the screen, I can put dice in there in between rolls, and it won't re-roll them. So I can put something down there, re-roll, and then decide what I want to do later based on what the outcome of the other dice are. So if it's putting doubles down there and hoping for triples, or putting a five down there and maybe hoping I roll a six for some reason, just to put the dice in different places, maybe I want to put it into the research, or if I want to use it differently according to specialty and clearing the term, the module itself. Certainly, it's a good dynamic to get into, holding dice that you're going to put into the repair anyway. Unless you can clear the repair and get rid of the hazard dice, it's probably better off holding them and then re-rolling just to see what your options are if you rolled high enough numbers to then utilize a specialty somehow and clear the module. So being safe here, knowing I'm going to go into next round, I'm contemplating what to do. Whether I risk it, take the damage away from the ship, or if I go into here and save the health damage I'm going to get on all our, I would say employees, but all our astronauts, I don't know what to call them, our crew. So we waste one assist with the three. The five and six are good enough to clear this terminal, and then I have the one and three to reroll. Hopefully I put the three on the bottom and reroll the one. Because if I re... Well, I'm not going to... Okay, so this is what I was talking about before. I'm not going to risk using up assists here because I cleared the event. So no matter what I roll, I'm not going to hit stasis or void or injury if they were there. It's a free roll, so I'm hoping for a 2 or a 6 to put on the bottom, or a 5 to bump up the assists. Even though it's diminishing returns, it will give me one more instead of the 3 it normally gives me. But I can't put the 5 on the bottom for research projects anyway. What I could do is find a way to use the 1 on the bottom to put the 1 in there. But I rolled a 2 and I put it in the research projects anyway. So I have 5 banked in research projects. So I can use any of those cards. The prevent stasis cards is also prevent injury, prevent void. They last the whole round. Not just the one roll in the module, and they don't carry over for the whole game. That's interesting. I can give Kayla 3 dice right now using the 1, 2, and 3 in my research project. So to use it, I click the... You have to have not taken a turn yet. And you click the crew member, and then you click the card to use it. If it's a card that reduces damage in a terminal, let's say, you got to bring the crew member into the terminal, into the module first, then use the card, and then they're stuck with their turn in that module. So it's you can't... If I had a card that repaired 15 damage, I can't just use it in the front of the ship and then take Kayla out and go to a different module to farm something else. I'm stuck in that module to clear it, so. Interesting here. I am farming for food. I have no food. I need dice, so I need doubles. And they're double fours. They're triple fours. So I can get 2 more food for next turn by putting all my fours into the specialty of the module. And then I can put my 1 and 2 in my research project, so I can use my last roll to try to get a 5 and get Kayla some health. And double 3s, so I'm going to waste the 3 here. I can put the 3 in the research project. Then I can use my override card, get rid of the 3 and the 4, and then put the 3 into research projects. Or I'm going to shuffle my cards. Use the 1 research project saved, and it goes low to high, like I said before. So use the 3, and I can put the 3 right back in there. So now these cards, I have +1 food, +1 ship, +3 crew health, and it's 2 or 3 for each of the cards. That's pretty good. And here's our impending damage. It's 1 and our cutscene going into next round.
I let my fear get the better of me, but the others have proven me wrong. I'm proud of how the crew has come together. I think we might actually have a chance.
And our actions. +1 health for all crew, +20% stress for you guys. And +1 ship and -1 health for you guys. So that would bring Kayla to 1 health, Jean to 3 health. I think 1 health all crew and adding stress is the better option. Everyone would be at minimum 3 health. Pascal would be at 4 health. Jean will be at 5 health. That's the better choice. Stress is I'm going to use one food on Jean. And I can get diminishing returns if I put it on Allison and Pascal, getting only 2 dice because 5 is maximum. But I'll hold it for next turn. Our new events, double damage dice in leak warning. Roll a 1, get damaged twice. 26 on that event. Up top, I have a 10 with 2 stasis dice. Every round, it takes a die away from everybody else. And on the right, I have a 12 event. 1 injury die, 1 stasis die, minus 1 health for all. Excuse me. The bane of this game is letting these things linger and stack. So by leaving that thing on the front of the ship, that event on the front of the ship, and then the one before I left in between rounds, you get 2 or 3 events per turn, and then they just start stacking up. That 26 I cannot take care of with a single crew member. 4 dice is the maximum I have. 24 is the maximum I can roll. And then I'm also risking injury there as well. Any one will use an assist, but if I exhaust all my assists, any one will give 2 damage to my crew member. So I'm going to probably take Jean in there last because he has the most health and really try to get rid of that. It also gives 2 damage to the ship, that event. And if we don't clear that UIO warning, that first event on the left, we're going to blow up. You have that little icon up top that says destruction imminent. We're having a bad time right now. We need ship health or we need to take care of all these events. So we're going to try first with Jean. I'm going to take Jean in there first. Kayla's already in there. So I think I'm hoping for high rolls here and adding a die to Jean and Kayla, as I'm showing you right there. Because Kayla's already in the module, so anybody in the module gets +1 to all dice. 1, 3, 5, 6. Probably bank the 6 and the 5. And then re-roll the 1 and the 3. And then just see what I get going forward with this. Because if I get double 1s too, like, I'll use both assists, but I might just put those into harvest food to have food for next round. So there's another assist I use with the 1. And then the 6. 6 is obviously good towards the repair or towards the +1 dice. I didn't say this before. I'm going to put the 1 in research projects because 1 really doesn't matter when you have to bring a second person into this module. But I could also put the 1 on the harvest food on the right. Then the second person who comes into this module could also roll a 1 because that first 1 would remain and then get food that way. They wouldn't have to roll 2 1s. A 1 would already be there, any other 1, and they'd be able to benefit from that. Just like I said before, if somebody gets health in the medical bay, the next person that goes in there, they can't use that specialty because that other person's die is still there. So I have the +1 quick patch card. So if I can get rid of that leak warning, I can use the +1 ship quick patch card and stay alive for next turn. So it's all a matter of who I want to bring where. Allison's already in the laboratory. She has 3 dice. 1 and 2 are stasis dice, so it's scary. But, you know, I just need 3, 3, 4 and higher. Or even with a 1 and a 2, I can still clear the terminal. I just can't roll both. I have 1 assist. And you can also farm assists in here. So I might try to do a little bit of both. 5, 5, 5 is ideal. Both go into the repair and then the other 5 into the assist. So we can tackle that double damage roll. Double damage room. But I rolled a 1, used the last assist. 10 to repair this module. I rolled a 10. Hard to imagine I wouldn't just clear this module and get it over with. Any other reroll and I'm stuck not clearing the module and bringing someone else in here, but I'm rerolling. Wow, I'm tough. I'm a tough guy. And there's a stasis die, and now I'm probably going to clear the terminal and bank the 2. Because my mindset is just clear the terminal, and I could have cleared the terminal the first time, but at least rerolling, I did make out in that that attempt because I got an extra die in the research area. Now, with Kayla and Pascal left, I'm still at 3 damage and still at 1 HP on the ship. So I'm really hoping Kayla can take care of that leak warning, and I should probably do that first. Very scary because she can die. So maybe I bring Pascal in there with 3 dice, But again, not only could he get injured or die, but he could also not clear the nine on less favorable rolls. I think what I'm showing here is I'm going to bring Pascal back into the laboratory and roll for assists. And then, okay, I'm giving him +3. I'm using a card. So Pascal just got +3 health. And now he's probably going to roll in leak warning. Just in case he rolls ones, he stands a better chance to live. Take whatever I can get out of the one roll. And hopefully that's enough. But no, I'm bringing him up to... Why would I give him health and bring him there? Okay. I did it. I don't know why I did it, but I did it. So he's rolling 3 dice. Any 5 or higher, and I get the assists I'm looking for. And with one roll left, it didn't look good so far. So I need a 5 or higher to get assists so Kayla can roll safely in the other module. And there's our 5. That gives me 3 assists, and then the 2 and the 3 can go in research projects. I think once I did that that move with the card, I quickly realized that was a bad idea. I think I caught it then. I guess the idea was to take him there, but then I realized that the 1 is double damage, and we have no assists. So even then, any 3 ones, and I would die. Alright, so Kayla's going in there now. Full assist. I used a card. I don't remember. I didn't check what the card was. So I was looking away. Was it +1 die? It might have been. No, it was ship health. That's right. 1, 3, 4, 5. Use one of my assists with the ones. That is 13, though. So the 4 and the 5 go up there. The event dice go away. And now I can freely re-roll these 2 dice for next turn, hoping for health. It will give her and Jean health. Or if I get doubles, I can get 1 food for next turn. Or I can put the 1 and the 3 on the bottom and just hold, be able to use more cards. +1 food card is good. +1 assist is always welcome in a pinch. And duct tape, 3 repair to 1 module. And they only cost 1 dice each. So might have been beneficial to put them in research projects. But I think I'm going to reroll for the health. Reroll for the health and to put something in research projects. And I did. So there's the 5. So the 5 can go into her specialist ability. Gives both her and Jean HP. Jean will then be at cap HP. 6 HP. Kayla will be in 4. Good place. And I put a die down there. And I use a dot. All 3 research projects die on the card to give me +1 food. So impending damage. We take 1 damage. Everyone gets -1 health. And your cutscene.
I've checked our food stores and it looks grim. Lost more than half our supplies with the module. If we don't find some creative solutions, we'll starve before we ever reach Mars.
All right, and our choices first. +1 assist, +10% stress for all crew. And I don't know if I remember what my assists are, but if I can go to view ship on the top left, I can see what they are. +1 to the ship, -1 health for all crew. Well, that's kind of devastating because we have an event out there lingering that's -1 health. So we probably don't want to do that. Take Allison down to 1 health. And then all of a sudden Allison needs health for next round to survive. So +1 assist. +10% stress for all crew. Seems the better of the choice. I will probably take that. The not chosen action on the right hand card. The right choice. Will give them stress as well. I'm really going to take that. That just seems stupid. Okay. So I have 2 food. 1 from the card. 1 left over from the turn before. And that crew person that was injured. That died in that opening tutorial. 1 got blown away in the module, that pantry, and then 1 on board died. Well, they can now be eaten. We can cannibalize them. If anybody eats any of that cannibalized meat, they get 2 dice as opposed to the 3 dice for the regular food, and they lose like 1 health container. They lose 1 off their maximum health. They don't lose 1 health. They lose maximum health. So if I give it to Allison right now, she'll be at 1 HP out of 5 instead of out of 6. She wouldn't lose that 1 HP. Pascal gets the food. Allison probably gets the food. Cannibalism also like increases stress to maximum, I believe. And also makes your dice meaty to roll. They roll with like blood stains and stuff. So There's an achievement behind cannibalism. There's also a character that you have to unlock behind cannibalism. I think they're both at the same rate. Doing the achievement gets you the character. So you have to do it. There's also an achievement to not be a cannibal. I already did that off stream. That was in one of my three games I played before this. And then there's also point system at the end of the game. And being a cannibal decreases your points and also decreases your points based on the stress as well. So the two lingering events are still there in the front and the back of the ship. We got a 17 event that has one injury die and one stasis die. And then a 15 event right in the middle that gives one injury die. 4 impending damage overall in this ship. 1 minus 1 health all damage on this ship. And we only have 2 ship HP. So we pretty much have to get ship HP, clear one of the modules that give us damage on the ship, and clear the health all or give Allison health as well. But if we can't clear events, you're seeing it right now, they're stacking up. And it won't be long before, like, we just can't handle it. There's just nothing we can do except for roll just for the sake of getting closer to end the game. The little pause here is just basically trying to think of how I can maximize benefiting our crew and minimizing the amount of events that are there that can be realistically taken out. Allison and Pascal have the most dice. They can roll a 30 maximum. Jean and Kayla can only roll 18 maximum. So it's really all about who's going to clear what and who's going in what order. Jean and Kayla are in the same module, so they can both take care of that. If they move anywhere else, they'll take damage. But if they both roll in this module, they can help each other out with health and dice, as well as repair the unit. 1 is stasis, 3 is injury, that's 2 of our assists gone. 6 is the most we can roll, so I'll probably bank that and reroll. I have 1 more assist left. Best case scenario here is to get a 5 and a higher and like something like a 3 and a 4. So I can use his specialty and then also contribute as much as I can to the repair. I can't sacrifice that 6 into his specialty, so I can't get dice for everyone else. Since I have to bring Kayla into this module, I'm not going to put the 2 to repair. I'm going to bank the 2 so that 1-2 is now worth 3 repair because of that duct tape card. So it's a little min-maxing there. I used a 2 die for like a 3 damage card, 3 repair card. Or at the very least, 1 assist so that somebody can roll a little bit safer. I'm taking Allison to the medical bay. It in retrospect, and knowing what I know now, not based on this game or this run per se, but knowing what I know about this game, probably a bad idea. But at the same time, anywhere she rolls, she'll die if she rolls that number. So with 5 dice, that's very risky to roll anywhere without an assist with 1 HP. So 2 options I have is bring her into the medical bay, roll a 5 or higher, and get full health with it, and then contribute as many dice as I can towards the research project, or bring her up to the laboratory, which any 5 or higher will give the crew 3 assists, and then again, contribute anything I have towards the research projects. Her specialty is passive, remember, so I can't roll an additional 5 or higher and do something else. So basically, it's 5 or higher for health, and everything else goes into research projects. I did not roll a 5 with 5 dice. And, okay, I rolled a 5. So the 5 is going to be used. She's going to go to full health. The 3 and the 4 are going to be used to research projects. I can use something that takes away cards. So then I can use the 3 and the, put the 3 and the 4 back in research projects. But I have nothing useful right now. I can take 1 assist, but that's just going to take away the 2. I can't use the 7 repair or the 3 repair because this module is not damaged. So I am, unless I re-roll for more cards and try to find a 2 card, that's pretty much useless. And then I had 1 more re-roll because that's Allison's specialty. Re-roll to 2 and a 3. Use the card that costs 1 research die for plus 1 assist. And then put the 2 back into research project. So that was basically a free assist. If any dice are left on the table that you can't do anything with, it kind of gives you a warning saying, do you really want to leave the module? That's what you just saw right there. Yes, I do, because there's nothing else I can do within there. So I have one assist. So relatively safe to do anything. I can use the 7 repair in that module is basically what I'm saying. The 7 repair or the 3 repair I can use in any of these modules. I just have to take someone in there first. So if I take Gene in there, let's say, and he can't roll an 8 or higher with 2 dice, he can use the 7 repair module at the cost of 2 research dice. And hopefully, like, he can at least contribute a 1 towards the repair, which is automatic. And the other die is a 5 or higher to give Kayla and himself another die for next turn. Kayla can actually use that die this turn because she didn't go. So she can roll 4 if I can do that, and then Jean will have at least 3 starting next turn. Oh, Jean already went. I'm sorry, Jean already went. So, ignore everything I said. If Kayla goes in there, same scenario. She can contribute at least 1 towards the repair. Hopefully roll a 5 or higher to give her and Jean health. Or just take care of it herself and then use the 7 repair card somewhere else. So there's an 8, and I rolled a 5. Both 1s go into stasis. So this is like the worst possible scenario there is. She took damage and now has to roll a 6 to clear this terminal. Or I used the 1 towards... Well, yeah, there you go. I used the 7, 7 card. So at the cost of, what was that, 3? 3 dice? 2 dice, I think it was? I repaired the module with 7. I can put the 1 and the 3 back in the research projects and then use a single die to repair the module. And that's what I do. So I use my safety net, or one of them. Certainly the better of the two, because that 7 could have been useful somewhere else. One guy left to go. 2 ship HP, 3 impending damage, so I have to take care of that 15 in the middle to survive, because it's 2 damage to the ship. Or, with Pascal, I can take that event on the end, and that the minus 1 health of all, the scattered supply event, and not only clear that event, but it would farm ship HP as well. I have no assists, so I give Pascal the health on the card, and I'm going to take him into there. So I'm going to try to get out of here with 2 ship HP and only 1 damage impending left on the ship between rounds. 5 dice, have to roll a 15. There's injury die, no assists, just hoping for no 4s. And I roll 3 2s and 2 3s. I roll a full house. It's good for 25 points in Yahtzee, but it is not good at all here. It's only a total of 12. So at this point, do I just save dice to minimize injuries? Or do I just roll everyone again? I could put dice into the module's specialty and gain 2 dice. But he's already at 4 dice for next turn. And that's diminishing returns. And we already established we don't like that. So we roll all the dice again. We rolled 1 4. He took 1 injury. And we rolled a 13 out of 15. So not only could we not do what we needed to do here, but we can't get out of this round alive. I shouldn't say that. We can put the 1 down to research projects, use the duct tape card, because that repairs 3-1 module, and have just enough to repair this module. And that's what we did. The 12. So we got lucky. We had 2 bad rolls. We got lucky. That's it. And the round's over. We have 2 ship HP. We have 1 impending damage. But we have 2 events lingering on the board, so... Minus 1 health also, so after the cutscene, we'll see our options.
A transmission arrived. Not from Earth, but from Mars. From Tharsis. An impossible signal from an impossible source. Is this what we're searching for? Who's transmitting this signal? Was there another mission to Mars? One sent before ours? Or is the message coming from someone else?
All right, 3 choices here. The higher the stress gets, it seems like the crew stops working as a team and everyone has their own individual options that also like trigger stress for them if they're not chosen. First option is just 2 flat assists. There's no penalty to that, so that seems like the best option so far. Minus 30 stress for Allison, but minus 1 dice. We can't afford that. And plus 3 health for Pascal, but minus 1 die for all crew. We can't risk that either. So the plus two assist is a very solid choice right now. We get one assist in between turns, and we had none after last turn, so we'd be full in assists. Wouldn't have to farm for them, and we don't risk dice on one person or everybody. I mean, I can do the middle option for Allison, lose one die on her, and then have her eat a piece of cannibalized meat. But really, I'm just losing resources if I do that at the cost of stress, and who cares about stress at this point? We have too many things lingering. We've got to fix stuff. So we need the dice. We need the dice. We need the resources. So plus two assists is the way to go. And we're at one ship HP, and we're going to take three damage this turn, too. Or two... Was it... I'm sorry. I forget what it was. We got rid of the one in the middle. Okay. We have no food left, so Kayla can't eat a piece of food for dice. But we're desperate right now, so Jean and Kayla are probably going to both eat a piece of human meat. Hey, what do we get? It gets us closer to an achievement, right? Once I get to that end game where I have everything unlocked and all the achievements, I'll worry about score then. I did not eat the meat. I don't know what I was trying to prove there. But now we have a 30 event in the middle, hull breach, and then we have another minus one dice all event. And that 30 is big. I mean, Kayla and Jean could have stand to use two dice each just to get rid of that. Three incoming damage pending for the ship. We have one ship HP. We have to take care of that 30 and that 15 event on the first part of the ship to survive. And even then, we lose dice and we lose health if we can't clear anything else. That 30 is going to be tough. Max roll on Allison and Pascal right now is 24. And three stasis dice in there as well. So let's not overlook that. Anything that's not a 4 and above cannot be rerolled or eats an assist. And apologies for those sounds. When I played this game originally, I think I've since fixed it, but I've only got that happening during this game. My mouse would re-detect in Windows 10. So I think I've since fixed the problem, or the problem, you know, has basically been narrowed down to only happening in Tharsis. So apologize for that happening going forward. It happens quite often. Not too much, but it happens more than it should. Basic strats right now is to bring Pascal into that end area, because not only could he reroll for ship health based on his specialty, but he can also reroll ship health based on the module's specialty. Allison has the most rerolls, so we got to figure out where her rerolls can benefit everybody. And we're actually going to bring her into here to reroll for ship repair, which is not a bad idea. We have all those assists. We just need doubles, and we took care of two assists and rolled doubles at the same time, so we can put that in ship repair. We'll be at three ship health with three impending damage still to go, and this module won't even be cleared because we only rolled a 10 on top of it. So I do that. I put the ones in the ship repair. Go to three ship health, hold the six, reroll the four, hoping for another six, and I did it. Miracle roll. And I take care of the events. So that event was just basically one minus one health for all. So that wasn't even something that could kill us this turn. It could hurt, but not, you know, not really. Minus one dice to all is gonna hurt us. But we still have to take care of one of the events on the docket there on the left hand side. Else we will only have enough ship health for damage, go down to zero ship health, and we'll explode. So Pascal has the most dice, one assist left, and I used one assist here, but I rolled a 16. So I probably will take the 15 towards the ship repair, put the one in the research projects, and then be on with it. Go on with it. Or at no cost, I can reroll the one, because it's a free roll. If it's a one again, it goes into research projects. If it's a two or three, it goes into research projects or towards the event. And I gain three more. So I can contribute 19 towards the repair, or I can use the two fours, harvest one food, and contribute 11 to the repairs. With two other people coming into this module to reroll, I'm going to take the food, so I'm better set up for next turn. I'm going to take the ship health for some reason, and I'm going to put the 6 into the repair. I'm probably thinking if I can't repair this because of all the stasis dice, then at least I have enough ship health to live. But at the same time, if I can't repair this, that's 3 events still on the board with 2 or 3 coming next turn, and I'm in an unwinnable situation. Right about now, I'm probably saying that was a bad idea because Gene and Kayla only have 2 dice, and the maximum they can roll is 24 if they all roll 6s. So no matter what, this event's lingering to next turn, but I at least have enough ship HP for next turn. So it all depends what you wanted to do there. If you wanted to try to get rid of it as fast as possible, or if you wanted to grab that ship health, sacrificing the repair just to live another day. So rolling 2 dice. Now again, I can add a 4 to that harvest, to the specialty of the greenhouse, and add another piece of food. Like, Pascal's dice is still there. I can add to it. It's a team thing. If he filled it, I couldn't. It doesn't reset. I rolled an 11. Hard to imagine I'm not putting the 11 into the repair. I mean, forget about health. Don't do it. The health, it would give everyone health in that module, and right now 3 people are in that module. Oh, I did it. I gave everyone health. I left it at 18. This one's not going to go good. I can tell you right now. Gene's going to roll 2 dice. 1, 2, or 3 of stasis. And I rolled a 2 and 3. So maximum's 5. I can either put them both in research projects. Put one or the other in research project. Or contribute it to the repair. And this, you know, even if it both are into the repair, it's still a 13 for next turn. So someone needs at least 3 dice and a decent roll to get rid of it. Here's our between action event. 1 damage, 2 more damage, 1 ship HP, everyone loses a die, and here's your cutscene.
That suit, it's designed for the Ektomi. Nobody has them but us. So who are they? And where did they get them?
Alright, after action turns, plus 1 ship, minus 1 health, all crew. That's viable. Everyone would have 2 health or more. Plus 1 food, minus 1 dice for all crew. Well, you can't go more than one. You can't go less than 1 die, but that would bring everyone down to 1 die. Or plus 2 assists, minus 1 health for all crew. I'm checking my assists right now. I'm checking the damage right now. That will give me full assists. But the other option will give me 2 ship health. And that might be more viable, knowing that there are more events coming on the horizon as soon as I make my selection. But who knows? I was young. I was a young kid 4 days ago. Who knows what I would have done? I'm really drawing attention to the fact that that event is minus 1 dice roll. Or just practicing how well I can make circles with the mouse. So I take that option. I get 1 ship and everyone loses health. That seemed fine to me. Someone can eat food and go up to 3, you know, go up 3 more dice. I probably give that to Kayla. I'm seeing where everyone is right now, so I can give dice to the people who would benefit everyone in their module so they can act first. Probably give it to Kayla. She can give everyone health in that module. And everyone's eating right now too, so everyone will be at either 4 or 5 dice. Most likely 4 or 4 and 3 dice actually. I'm probably thinking, let's give it to Allison because she's got the rerolls, and that's exactly what I did. And everyone else is going to get 2 more dice. That leaves 2 crew members still at 3 dice. Once you eat all the cannibalized meat, you can kill a crew member and get more meat. If they die naturally in the game, which I, you know, pretty much is the only way you can die in the game, their meat will be added as well. So you don't necessarily have to kill them. You can wait for them to die and then get their meat. So there comes a big 30, a big 26, and a 19 over there. So we have 6 impending damage here. We have a minus 2 health all event, and we have a minus 1 dice all event. This is pretty bleak. Alice can roll 30 max, but that's really not realistic. Pascal can roll 24 max. Kayla and Jean can roll 18 max. So if all goes according to plan, Like, Allison can take care of the 30. Pascal can take care of, like, the 19 or the 11. Or, you know, Kayla can take care of the 11. Jean can take care of the 13. Pascal can take care of the 19. It's all not going that way, though. And even if I did that, we'd still have minus 2 health all up on the board. And that would kill Kayla and Pascal. So really, I have to figure out a way to survive here, and with the cruel fate of this game, I'm probably just surviving this round, and then next round would pretty much automatically kill me because I just couldn't do anything. But it's surviving this round, and best way to do that is take care of that whole breach. I go down to 4 impending damage. Allison takes care of the heat tank fail. I guess HE is a... that helium? Helium tank fail in the back of the ship. And farms for ship health at the same time in there. So that will bring 3 damage down. I'll have 2 ship HP with 3 damage. But if Allison rolls doubles, that'd be 4 ship HP with 2 ship health. So I rolled a 14. I got rid of this event. I could have put the 5s in the harvest food for the food because it required doubles. But we needed to get rid of that right now. So we're done. Now Pascal's gonna roll there. Interesting, because the ship health, the minus health all will kill Pascal, kill Kayla. So if Kayla and Pascal roll in there and get rid of the 26, they'll live next turn. And then Allison still just needs to roll doubles in the back of the ship. And take, that's not possible. She can't roll doubles and take care of the 19. Because that requires 5 dice, 2 for the doubles, and 3 dice is 18 max. So interesting to see what I do here. I have the plus 3 ship on the bottom, so maybe I roll Allison until she gets 5 dice in research projects, 5 unique dice, and use that repair arm card. All right. 5, 5, 5, 4. He can regain dice, but we don't have a round to live for next time. So I can take all 19 and put it into the repair. He can't get rid of the repair by himself, but he knocks it down to a 7, so when Kayla comes in here, she can finish it and give health to everybody else, or, like I'm pointing out there, I can use his specialty, get 1 ship HP, and then contribute the 14 to the ship repair, so Kayla's just coming in here with a 12 to take care of. But 3 dice, and 3 stasis dice at low numbers, so... That might be hard to do, but I have to take the ship HP and then just contribute the rest to the repair. Hope Kayla can come in here and finish the job. 3 dice, have to avoid the 1, 2, and 3. Have 1 assist, though, so I can slip up a little bit. And we'll see how we do. I don't know why I'm drawing attention to her specialty. That helps us. No, man. Look at that. Use the assist on the 1. The 1 and the 3 go to stasis. The highest I can roll right now is a 10. So, I have to reroll that 1. What that means is I have to reroll the 1. Hope to get a 5 or more. Put that in her specialty. And that's why I was pointing it out. So that her and Pascal can live another day. Because that will give 1 health to... her and him, because they're in the same module. So that's unfortunate, and I have to have that roll happen, or they die this turn. Or I bring Allison in here, have Allison defeat this so they can stay alive, but then the ship doesn't have any HP left, so everyone dies. So basically, Kayla has to roll for 5 or 6, or her and Pascal die next turn. How lucky was that? Look at that roll. RNG favored us on this turn. But not really, because... because we're probably leaving... Okay, so I'm going to use the 1, not towards the repair, but towards the ships for the module's specialty and get 2 dice back. Now, Allison has to roll for ship health. There's no doubt about it. Unless she can clear that 30 by herself on the bottom of the ship, which is... max roll on everything, staying away from 1s and 2s. She has to take care of that helium tank failure. Well, doesn't have to take care of the helium tank failure. I'm sorry, she can't do both. She has to get ship HP and then contribute the rest of it towards that repair. But that's leaving so many events on the board, it's hard to imagine that we can get rid of next, get out of here next turn. She took two injury, lost two HP because of that roll, because she rolled two fours. I think we just have to get out of here alive. Oh, she's dead. She's dead. Because we're going to take two HP's worth of damage on this turn. So, we're done. We have to take the ship repair so everyone else lives. And then I think throw the 15 into the repair. Because I can't clear it anyway, so might as well take what we have. Save the sixes, reroll the three. I guess we can do that, but she's going to die anyway. Maybe hope she gets another six or five or something, and then we can send Pascal in here next turn, clear the event, and farm to ship HP, but at this point, any sort of prolonged thought process going into this is really delaying the inevitable, and that's where we're dying next turn. Alright, so I am actually looking to see if I can keep Allison alive. And I did. I put one die, the three, down in research projects, re-rolled, used it to re-roll, and then got a card that was kind of like a band-aid to give her HP. So here you go. One ship damage. One minus one dice all. Two health all. Minus two health for the ship and minus one health for the ship. Now everyone's so stressed out that they have their own individual options. So left to right, minus 30 stress, minus 1 health all. Just for the stress is just for Kayla, so that's pretty selfish. Plus 2 food, but minus 5 health for Allison. She'll kill herself, but we'll have food. And not cannibalize food, that would be real Soylent Green. Pascal has plus 1 assist, but minus 1 dice for him, and he's already at 2 dice, so that's bad. Plus 3 ship, minus 5 health for Gene. That kills him, but the ship gets HP. So we have to figure out what we want to do here. That option by Kayla also kills Kayla, Pascal, and Allison. So I think minus 1 from Pascal, minus 1 dice, but plus whatever that was, ship HP? No, it wasn't ship HP. Whatever it was. The only thing that kept alive. Kept everyone alive. And, yeah, I don't know why I didn't use the cannibalized meat there. I don't know what I was thinking. I think maybe I was trying to do a run without using cannibalized meat. Or did I use it all last turn? I didn't notice. I really wasn't looking in that area. But we just added events to every module of this ship. We have 6 impending damage. We have 4 people still alive. 2 of them have 1 die. 2 of them have 3 dice. We have a 19, a 30. They both have 2 damage. So somehow we have to get rid of 4 damage and roll doubles where Allison is to live with 2 assists. That large fire has 3 injury dice. A 5 takes away 1 HP. The 6 takes away 2 HP. We have 2 assists, like I said. And at this point, I just realize it's pretty much over because we had that minus 2 health all also, which will kill pretty much everyone at this point. So now it's just roll and be on with it. So there's the 9. And then 2 to research projects, I'm sure. No, I'm going to re-roll it for health for some reason. There you go. All right. So that's done. So at least we're not going to get injured next turn. So somehow we survive and get 6 HP for the ship, or, you know, take care of that large fire and get 4 HP. It's pretty much over. So there's a 5. That's an injury dice, but we had an assist. So 5 towards the repair, 14 left, and we'll probably bring Gene in here now. Gene only has 1 die, too, so it's I don't even know what I'm really doing. We could have put dice towards research projects and used that 28 repair and or the 17 repair and probably gotten out of it. But the writing was on the wall. The next turn would have definitely killed us. 6-6-5, probably as good as a roll as you can get. Ship repair, but it doesn't matter. Reroll that for another 6, but she's the last one acting, so... 1 and 1, 1 is useless. Put it to the ship repair, and then that's it. We're done. There's all the impending damage. That one kills us, and then there's still more. -1 dice for all. -2 for the ship. -1 dice for all. -1 to the ship. So that's Tharsis, baby. That's exactly what happens when runs go bad. You let things linger. You can't clear things right away with favorable rolls, and then you just keep getting events the next time. Hindsight, I've seen some mistakes. Maybe I could have saved it, but who knows? I still needed the rolls. Here's your after-game actions, your scoreboard. 7 turns survived, 20 events completed, 1 research done, 4 dead crew, 3 human meals. I did eat them all the turn before. 6 events remaining, which is probably a 7 is probably maximum. 100% stress. We lose points there. We only scored a 745, which is terrible, and we are done. So, hope you enjoyed the video. I apologize again for the re-recording of the audio I had to do. It's such a rookie mistake, and I feel so stupid because I did it. But hopefully I explained it better than I would have, and I think I did. If you enjoyed this video, check out my other Tharsis videos. Episode 3 begins the live commentary again. Episode 2 is going to be voiced over. Please subscribe to the channel. If you enjoyed it, give it a like. Check out my other videos. More games to come. Check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/angrylarry. And follow me on Twitter, @LarryIsAngry. Thanks, everyone, and I will see you again soon. Enjoy.